You must have seen that in your home, there are a variety of appliances that run on electricity, like a bulb, a fan, a heater, or even an iron. Now, the same electricity which makes the bulb glow makes the fan rotate. And the same electricity also enables the heater and iron to get heated up. So how do you think electricity is able to behave in these different manners? Let us quickly find out. Whenever electricity is passed through an appliance, the appliance gets heated. Let us take a very simple example. Let's say that you have switched on your laptop or your computer and you have kept it switched on for a long period of time. After a while, if you touch the back of your computer screen or the bottom of your laptop, you will find that it has become heated up. A similar example can be taken in the case of a pedestal fan. If you keep the pedestal fan rotating for a long period of time, after a while, if you touch the bulb at the back of the fan, that is the bulbous back of the fan, you will find that it has also heated up to a good extent. So we can say that whenever electricity is passing through any appliance, that appliance is getting heated up, as you saw in the case of the laptop as well as the fan. So this effect of heating up is known as the heating effect of current. That is, whenever current passes through an appliance, the appliance is heated up. So we consider now a simple example to derive mathematically how we can express this heat. We have considered a very simple circuit where the cell is providing a potential of V volts. Now we have connected a simple appliance like a fan. Now let me tell you that every appliance that is connected in a circuit has a resistance of its own. This resistance is often unfavorable because in case of a fan, the job of the fan is to rotate through the incoming electricity. This resistor or this resistance is basically an unwanted resistance which is in the inside of the fan. Now, when electricity is passed through the circuit, the fan will rotate and the work done, which will be used to move the charges, will be given by Q into the potential difference across the circuit. So, as I mentioned, this R is the internal resistance of the fan. The electricity that is consumed in two parts. First, the electricity is used to rotate the fan, and another part of electricity is consumed by this resistor. So we shall find out what happens. Now we know that power is nothing but the work done divided by time taken. So in this case, we calculate power as QV divided by T, which is equal to the current flowing through the circuit multiplied by the potential difference developed across the circuit. Now, as I told you, every appliance has a resistance. Similarly, the fan that we have considered in this circuit also has a resistance of its own. This resistance, through which current passes, heat is dissipated. So the same current, which is being converted into mechanical energy and making the fan rotate, a part of this current is being used up by the resistor and getting dissipated as heat energy. So we will find out how much energy is being dissipated as heat. So we have seen that power is nothing but energy supplied by time taken. So we can rearrange this expression and write energy supplied to the resistor in time t is nothing but power into time. We saw that power is I times the potential difference IV, and we represent time as t. So we can represent energy supplied to the resistor in time t as IV into t. So thus, we write IV into t using the relation t equals IV. Now we know that V is equal to IR. That is, from Ohm's law, we know V is equals IR. So if we replace the value of V in this equation, what will we get? We will get I into IR into T. which is nothing but I square into R into T. Thus, using the relation from Ohm's law, we get the energy supplied to the resistor in time t as I square RT. This is known as joule heating. That is, the value of the resistance of the fan is R, and the current passing through the fan is I, and it is being used for time t seconds. So under the circumstances, the heat energy that will be dissipated by the fan is given by this formula, and this effect is known as joule heating. So the amount of heat produced in time t is equal to the amount of energy supplied to the resistor in time t, and it is equal to I square RT. So I square RT is the energy that is getting dissipated in the resistor, which is getting dissipated as heat energy. So the amount of heat produced in time t is H equals I square into R into T, which is known as joule heating. Now, how do you think the effect of joule heating can be minimized? Let me give you a simple analogy. Whenever there is a leak in a water pipe, the water that is coming to your home from the water supply will not be the same as the water that you get from the taps at your home. Why? Because somewhere in between, if there is a leak, there will be loss of water. Amount of water will be lost that is coming from the supply to your home, and the remaining amount of water will reach your home. Similar happens in the case of the fan which we just considered, or any other electrical appliance. If the resistance of that particular appliance is more, a great amount of energy will be lost as heat energy. So how do you think we can minimize the effect of joule heating? As you can see from the expression, if either of I or R or even T is minimized, then we can decrease H. If we use a low value of current, or if we use a low value of resistance, or even if we use the appliance for a less amount of time, low amount of heat will be generated. But the most feasible way in order to reduce the effects of joule heating is to reduce the value of R, that is resistance. So if we use a low value of resistance, we will find that the effect of joule heating is greatly minimized. Now, joule heating is an effect that is not always disadvantageous. Joule heating can be used to our advantage as well. Let us find out how. Now, the picture that you see is that of a fuse wire. A fuse wire is a device that is usually encased in a porcelain container, and it is used for the protection of circuits. Let us find out how a fuse wire protects circuits. A fuse wire is a material which is an alloy of 50% lead and 50% tin, and the melting point of this alloy is at 200 degrees Celsius. So a fuse wire is a device which is always connected in series with an appliance, any appliance, in order to protect it. Now let's see how the appliance is protected with the help of a fuse wire. So this fuse wire is a material which has a very high resistance. So let's say there has been a fault in the lines and an excessive amount of current passes through because of this fault. Let's say it is a short circuit or an overloading. So due to this excessive amount of current, if a fuse wire is not used, then this excessive current will damage any appliance that is connected. But now if we use a fuse wire, we find that it has a high resistance. Also, an excessive amount of current is flowing through the fuse wire because it is connected in series with the appliance. As we can see, the melting point of the fuse wire is quite low, 200 degrees Celsius. So if we use the formula I square into R into T, we will find that during a fault, I is very high, as well as R, which is very high for a fuse wire. So a great amount of heat will be generated, and this leads to the melting of the fuse wire. So when the fuse wire melts, it breaks the electrical circuit. That is, it cuts off the appliance from the connection. So what happens? The moment the fuse wire melts, current no longer flows in the circuit, and the appliance is protected from the damaging effects of this excessive current whenever there is a fluctuation, short circuit, or overloading of any kind. So we saw the application of Joule heating in the case of a fuse wire. Where else do you think Joule heating is employed? Joule heating is also used in the case of a bulb as well as in case of a heater. In the case of a bulb, a tungsten filament is used. That is, this part, which is known as the filament, is made of tungsten. Tungsten has a very, very high melting point of around 3380 degrees Celsius. So such a high melting point ensures that it does not melt when a high amount of current passes through it. And tungsten also has a very high resistance. So when even a reasonable amount of current passes through tungsten, it gets heated up to a great extent because R is very high. So this heat energy that is developed in tungsten is converted to light energy. And this light is what we see when we switch on a light bulb. Likewise, in case of a heater, the Joule heating effect is used in order for the heater to work functionally. What happens is, the heater consists of coils which have a very high resistance as well as a high melting point. So when a given amount of current is flowing through the coils of the heater, the amount of heat that is generated is very high. So this is the heat that we get from the heater and what keeps us warm during winters.